Hello guys, hope you are doing good. This is silverfoxa and today I'm going to share with you how to create subdomain. In our previous video we discussed on how to link our domain to the DigitalOcean server. In case you haven't checked, I'll put the link in the description. Hope you'll find it informative enough. Now let's get started with creating a subdomain. For that, let's go to our DigitalOcean console. Plus, let's open up the terminal. Okay, let's go to the droplet that we have created last time. Okay, now we need to get into the terminal and access the droplet. I showed you how to do that in the previous video. And we're accessing as the root user. I'll copy this IPv4 address. Paste it. It will ask you for the password. Okay, so once you're in, you get to see the PHP MyAdmin credentials here. Let me just arrange the terminal window for a second. If you like this application, I'll put the link in the description. It's called Magnet. Comes really handy when you want to manage all the windows on your screen. So this is the HTML directory which gets reflected when I type in flowerdecorator.in. Now we want to create a subdomain, so let's create a separate directory for that. We'll label it as subdomain for now. The directory has been created. Now we need to grant it the read write permission. It has the required permission. Let's get into subdomain. We'll create a simple HTML file so that we get to see if it's working fine or not. It works fine. Okay, good. It works is enough. One more thing that we need to do here. Okay, first thing, we'll come to networking. Let's get into domain flowerdecorator.in, which we have configured previously. Now we need to create a subdomain, right? So what would be that name? For this, let's give it as test. That would be our subdomain name. So here you can see test.flowerdecorator.in. So that way the subdomain has been created for it. It's not created, we have to do it now. Now it needs to be redirected to a droplet. Now all these are private droplet, like private networking has been enabled for all of those that we did in the previous one. So we'll just select this classic flower decorator. So this is the subdomain which has been created for us. Now if you try to see, it will redirect to the home page, that is flowerdecorator.in. okay, now in order for the subdomain to work, we have to include the virtual host and configure it. That we will do, and before that let's just create a cname record. I believe you know what is a cname record, as we have done it in the previous one. Okay, so our cname records have been configured, and I'll just copy the URL because that will be needing in creating or configuring the virtual host. Let's go to the root directory. Now from here we have to go to /etc/. Okay, before creating a virtual host, you need to ensure that Apache is installed. Okay, and if in case it's not installed, you do apt get it. Okay. And I'll install it. Install Apache. For us, we have the Apache installed because we chose that on-click application with the LAMP configuration, where Apache, PHP, MySQL, and all this thing are already installed. So we need not get bugged with that. But in case if you don't have, just try to install those. We'll go to cd /etc/apache2 and within that we need to get into sites available. Okay, so we'll get into sites available. So we want to copy the default configuration that we have here. Let's copy this into our test. test.com.configuration. So now we'll edit the config file. Okay, this is a dummy one. Now we need to configure the server name here. Server name is this thing. Paste. And we need to assign a server alias, because we want it to work under our www thing. Now we need to ensure the document root is set properly. So our directory was under www, and within that we have something called subdomain, right? And so that thing is configured. Now for some application, they might need you to redirect all the traffic to public directory. So in that case, within that directory, there will be a subdirectory called public. I'll share with you in brief regarding this stuff in next video, where we'll be installing Slim framework on DigitalOcean server, plus the Slim skeleton. Okay, once this is done, we need to ensure that the virtual host files are enabled. To do that, we'll go to a sudo user, that is the root user, and we'll enable the virtual host config. Okay, sorry, this is okay. So this will get enabled. Now one more command that we have to type in to ensure that the default configuration are not active, right? To do that, okay, for me, I have already created a subdomain called pub live, where all the live website files are residing. Anyway, I'll just key in the command so that you can see, and in case you haven't done, can do the same. It says it has been already disabled. Now we need to restart our Apache server for it to work. Test. There you go. So it's working fine now. Hope you find the video informative enough. Please do subscribe my channel and like or share, whichever you prefer the best. Thank you.